It's the Australian way to cast your vote. No, not that Australian way. Gross. I'm talking about preferential voting.
You mark the ballot paper, not me.
Your chance to choose not only who you want in charge, but who you don't want.
You put it in order of your choice where you want your vote to go.
Preferences, those little boxes that you number on the ballot paper, come into play when none of the candidates in your electorate wins outright with more than 50% of the vote. In that situation, whoever came last is eliminated, and the second choices of everyone who voted for that person then get distributed among the relevant contenders. That process is then repeated until those preferences tip someone over the magic 50% mark.
People think political parties direct preferences. They don't. Voters decide that. All that political parties can do is give you a recommendation in the form of a how-to-vote card.
Parties try to influence our preferences with those how-to-vote cards we get bombarded with on election day, and with good reason.
In tight seats, preferences are absolutely the difference between winning and losing for any MP.
Exactly who preferences whom and why is at times controversial. After months of railing against the major parties and vowing to put incumbents last...
The Liberal, Labor and Greens will all be at the bottom of our ticket.
Clive Palmer's United Australia Party is now preferencing the Liberals and Nationals ahead of Labor in a string of key marginal seats. Liberal MP Dave Sharma returning the favour, putting the UAP at number two, while Barnaby Joyce is under fire for putting One Nation second on his how-to-vote cards.
Not me.
Yes, you! Well, your local candidate anyway.
You see quite moderate MPs put parties like Clive Palmer's and Pauline Hanson ahead of established parties purely because they're trying to maximise their own chances of getting elected. So that's why you see some strange bedfellows.
But while some party preferences are about winning allies, others are more of a giant FU.
It's called being a goddamn bloody adult.
Jackie Lambie preferencing One Nation way down the list after their blow-up in the Senate last year.
And that's what this country's supposed to be about.
In the end, though, how much how-to-vote cards matter is entirely up to us.
It's actually voters that determine their preferences.
Not me, not anyone else but yourself.
We saw a high point in the mid-90s where just under 60% of voters followed a how-to-vote card. In the last election, that dropped to just under 30%. So you don't have to follow any preference deal. You can just do it as your heart decides.
It's called being a goddamn bloody adult.
Are you a goddamn bloody adult, Pete? How do you
always,
go?
Always. I tend to follow, if I've decided who to vote for, if it helps, I tend to follow the how to vote card.
Then you're not a goddamn bloody adult.
Well, I wasn't really paying that much attention. But I've seen that quote so many times. I love it, Jackie, I love it. But it's funny, I applied for a postal vote because I'm going to be away that weekend, and I'm trying to figure out where you go to find out your preferences, do I just not care?
You're going to have to pay attention and make up your own adult mind.
Oh, right? No. Come on. Please, no.
I think that they could really come into their own, especially this election. Apparently there's research saying that how-to-vote cards, they weren't as influential last election as they have been previously, but I think that they could now find their own again because a lot of people, we're not used to doing things. We've 2 years in a pandemic, it's confusing.
Right, okay.
You really, like, lots of people won't have the headspace. I honestly think that some people might just not have the headspace and they'll be like, okay, yep.
I also think that we don't like instructions anymore. We don't have the time, we don't have the patience. We throw it out fast and loose, get in there, put some numbers on a card.
But if we had instructions enough, we won't actually fill in the ballot paper properly at all.
You need to at least do that.
We should do that.
We need to do at
least
that.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Handy to take in case they run out of napkins for the sausage as well. So just something to keep in mind.